Dear faculty members and students, this meeting is all about the beginning of choice-based credit system that Honorable VC Madam wants to start with the choice-based credit system because it helps the slow learner and also the fast learner as well. Slow learners can improve their credits and the fast learner can complete their entire courses in 3.5 years or so, so that they can, you know, concentrate on their internship in the final year and they do not have to take courses simultaneously along with the internship. And there are different modalities that Madam will explain in her presentation and enlighten all of us. And I would request Honorable VC Madam to enlighten us with her presentation. And there is one request to all the faculty members and students that post Madam's presentation, you must only ask questions relating to the CBCS because this is an important topic and we should not deviate our questions and deviate from the topic by putting up questions on NPTEL or other aspects. For that, there are different forums and different ways in which you can ask the question. So I would request Madam to please begin with her presentation.
Over thank to you, Dr. Munish. Thank you so much, Dr. Munish, for taking up this lead. And good morning, dear students and dear teachers, to the another session of CBCS. So as dear students, everybody has been told. There were several mandate from the government to take up this. This is a beautiful system we can call choice-based credit system as it's a platter. You go to reception or when you have to, a best choice for cafeteria. Our food zone has various you know, stores and then which restaurant, which food you need to have, you can choose your food. How much quantity you need, how much you can eat, how much you can digest, and what to eat, where to eat, when to eat. Everything is based on your inputs and your choice. Similarly, the government of India in various initiatives in 2015-16, then in National Education Policy 2020, they have launched that the CBCS must be introduced across the university. So now with this background, what are the advantages? The advantages would be, this is shift in focus from teacher-centric to learner-centric. As I said, you need to decide what you want to learn, when you want to learn, what is your interest, can you take up some subjects from the other school, is it being allowed, when to allow, does it have some prerequisite, then you cannot. So you need to do the foundation course of other schools first, if at all it appeals. Suppose a student of computer science or BCA wanted to do a course in economics, or if you have learned AI, you want to learn AI with sociology or AI, how it is affecting economics. Can you do a project which is interdisciplinary? So the student, faculty of computer science and faculty of economics can join hands and then they can guide you. So is it possible the faculty of school of business and faculty of yours can join because you are working on your startup and that's your capstone project? Various things. So learner will, as a learner, you will have autonomy. You can choose your electives and majors even from interdisciplinary. I mean, there is a subject which is where you feel you are not interested or that doesn't go along with your the kind of courses you want to study. So in that case, you may take up, this is not my core, and I wanted to take up these subjects. You can have your broadened, you know, horizon. You right now you have one economic subject to ask for. I wanted to have two economic subjects. I want to learn micro economics. You can say, I wanted to learn a subject of maybe foundation course in financial because I'm working on my company wherein I have to handle financials. You can say, I'm working for agro business. I got a placement in agro business or I have a special interest. Can I learn the leaf engineering or maybe some other course, tissue engineering? So making this makes education more broad-based. This gives learner the mobility. as Dr. Munish has correctly said, we are giving you choice. You can be a fast learner, you can be a slow learner, you can be a normal student, mediocre. So in mediocre, you will not do much experiments. Fast learner would think of, oh, can I do my credits completion little early so that I can concentrate in final year only on my capstone project and competitive exams? Somebody would say, oh, I'm right now, my pointer is only 5. I need to get in 6 for getting placement. So this semester, I'm in a 4th semester. Next year, 5th sem and 6th sem, I'm going to have placement. I will not be eligible. Can I register less so that my pointer would increase? If I have registered for less number, I will take up less exam. If I have less number of exams, I will study more for those subjects. If I'll study more, my grades or marks will be better. Marks are better means grades are better. And grades are better means your earned grade point is better. It means your CGPA and SGPA is going to be the improved one. Now, what choices will be there? So we are allowing you to, in this semester, suppose your pointer is less, you can register only for 20 credits. If you are registered for 25, we will allow you to withdraw one course. Of course, the dean sir has to allow, and that too, the pointer which is less than 5 and so on, such cases. The students who are fast learner, their pointer is really good. They can go up to 30 credits. Choice in option of selecting courses from all offered courses list. You can select the, right now we are going to allow you for multi, the select the electives from the other schools. Select the electives from other school. You can, as I said, you can choose the electives from maybe media. You want to learn on the graphics part. You can select your electives from any other school. And for that, suppose you have already registered for elective, you can change your elective. We will allow you to change those courses in next 2-3 days. You can learn some additional subject just for the knowledge. So, of course, the exam is supposed to be given, but then you can learn the additional subject. So your degree is for 160 credits. You can register for 170 also. Undergraduate students having CGPA more than 7, you can do one course of PG. Of course, it is to be offered by the school in current semester. Suppose the School of Computing Science is offering AI and Data Science, you can do that course. If you are offering PG MTech in Cloud Computing, you can do a course from Cloud Computing. Facility of grade improvement for CGPA less than 6. That we have already launched from now, last semester. And you can do that, you know, if your pointer is less or grade improvement is possible for maximum 2 subjects. And these 2 subjects, maximum credits wherein you can apply for grade improvement during your 4 years tenure of engineering or 3 years of BSc or BCA, maximum 10% of subjects only you can apply for grade improvement. You, as a fast achiever, you can complete your degree in 3 years or 3.5 years for those who are in engineering. If you are in BCA, you can complete your degree for 2.5 years. So you can complete the credits, not the degree, but the degree would be awarded with the others in the convocation only. The slow learner can extend their degree up to N plus 2 years. If your course is program is for 4 years, it can be 4 plus 2, 6 years. If your program is for 3 years, it is 3 plus 2. If your program is 2 years, it is 2 plus 2. You can do your complete your credits. Always remember, fast learner, I have already said, fast learner can register the extra subjects. So now if your pointer is first semester and second semester, we are not going to allow you to change anything, withdraw or add. But third semester onwards, you are matured. You have understood the CGPA, SGPA system, internal, external assessment, and so on. We can allow you. Please remember, your exam registration would be different and your course registration would be different. Course registration, what you are going to study. The exam registration is what you are going to have in exam. It might be possible in CBCS, you have studied the subject, but you feel that you are not ready for exams for everything. We can allow you to make your one course earlier. It means you have studied. Now next semester, when you are going to study other subjects, you can give the exam as an earlier course in next semester. The exam registration right now is possible for 56-60 credits, which is very, very high. So we will give you a credit limit wherein you can apply for exam registration as well. This is applicable for engineering and non-engineering as well. please remember, I'm going to show you the promotion rules. These are very, very important for CBCS. You can take up any subject, you can drop any subject, you can register additional subject, you can do unregister one subject, you can take up electives from anyone. But please remember the promotion rules as well. It is all credit-based system, so credit-based promotion. First semester of engineering and BCA, suppose your first two semesters sum is 40. You are supposed to earn 40 credits in first year. So when you can enter into third term or second year, when you have completed 60% of credits from totality, including adding the credits which are there for semester one and semester two. If you have semester one and two total 40 credits, then 60% of that has to be earned before you get promoted to the third semester or second year. To get promoted to the third year, the total credits of your first year plus 60% of total credits of third and fourth semester together has to be earned before your promotion to fifth term. And seventh term, before promoting to the final year, you need to have total credits equals to first year, second year, and 60% of fifth and sixth. Automatically, all these formulas will be applicable in your iCloud. Ensure that your degree, you earn minimum 50%, 5-pointer. How to calculate CGPA? I'm sure you must be knowing that pointer. CGPA is nothing but 5 into 10. And for PG, it is going to be minimum pointer 6. So 6 into 10. So now for non-engineering also, it is going to be same. Now one more condition is there before you get promoted. It is already there from 1920. I'm making this statement over here so that if you are unknown, you should be known about all the rules of examination for your promotion. With minimum CGPA requirement in UG program for first 2 years is not mandatory. As I said, final year, you need to get in 5-pointer. So pre-final year, so to enter into final year, the condition would be 4.5 CGPA also to be there. So please ensure you get in 4.5-pointer before you enter into final year, minimum pointer. Now, what you can do in the CBCS and what you cannot do. So these are the options. Right now we have opened up this option, although you have registration is complete. Student above pointer 8 can choose PG courses. Student can choose elective from the other schools. Students can choose elective from other program of the same school. Like sociology can attend the program, some subjects of political science, or the cloud computing students can attend the programs, courses of the AI. Students can earn major and minor. They can enroll right from fourth semester or third semester. They can enroll for major 18 credits extra in the same domain wherein you have taken admission. These 18 credits could be some courses from PG, some could be from industry, some could be from EDX, some could be from Coursera, some could be, but then in the same domain. Computer science will do from computer science. Students minor. Students can register for minor wherein they have to earn 18 credits extra from the core of other discipline. Like if your BCA students are there, they want to do the minor in management. The students have to learn the basics of management subjects, 18 credits extra from the School of Business. They can do minor in entrepreneurship. They can do minor in law. They can do minor in sciences. They can do minor in, mathematics. So they have to define. So this is one. Now, the next is credit transfer. As Dr. Munish has said in the beginning, credit transfer CTS, we say as an abbreviation. So you know that seventh semester is going to be your placement week or placement semester. In that case, you are work. And then if after placement, you are supposed to work in the industry. At the same time, you have some subjects, seventh semester subjects are there. So now you can take up those subjects, complete those courses. And then as a fresh candidate, you will not have any burden from the university and you can complete your capstone project. And then you can get placed there, or you can complete your internship and next semester, eighth semester, you can enroll for maybe your competitive exams and study those. Next is grade improvement. I have already said, slow learner, you can register for 20 or 19 credits. Right now, we are allowing you to register one subject extra if that is there. So from Coursera, from EDX, and then the exam could be proctor-based in the campus or by the respective, you know, dean would elaborate how would be the exam pattern. The registration dates, the deans would open up all these registration by end of day today, that which schools are offering which subjects, which you can register. You have to give the choices to the dean on the Google Sheet or the methodology which they have appointed, allotted, and then intimated to you. And the program chair will approve or disapprove your registration details which you have applied for on 28th of December. And then extra registration for PG course or elective or whatever it is, that is going to be finalized by the 28th. And with this, we will start engaging those classes from 1st of January or 2nd of January for this new courses which you have. So you have to, while enrolling, you also have to see your timetable. So elective courses, only those you can apply wherein which fits into your timetable. Your elective timing and their timing should match. Otherwise, you can change your electives from Coursera and EDX as well. That is also allowed by the deans. So please ensure you do all these permutation combination. This will make your personality in totality. You know, you are not going to study only academics, but you are going to study the interdisciplinary domain, which is very, very essential for one's growth. So that's it from my side. And then the rest will be covered by Dr. Munish. You can also give, you know, if you have some specific question, I can take up those questions. Limited time, maybe next 5-10 minutes. Thank you so much.
Dear students and faculty, thank you, VC ma'am, for your, explanation of CBCS. I hope it will help people understand the whole concept. Dear faculty members and students, if you have questions, please type in the box and be very specific to CBCS. All other issues we can handle with the mechanisms that are already available. Please type in the chat box.
So I think right now there are no questions, Dr. Munish. So you can take up those questions and we can always have FAQ can be shared with me.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.